There's something I would like to share with you that's very dear to my heart. All my life, I've been involved with missions. At a very early age, our parents taught us the importance of reaching out to others. That's why I'm involved with World Vision. World Vision gives me a way to reach out to one child, one family, one community, and share the love of Jesus Christ. Not long ago, I was in Honduras with World Vision and met a very special family. Let me tell you about my visit. Every day, Elmer Sanchez gets up early to make the 2-hour walk to work. Elmer is 13 and lives with his mother and his four brothers in a small mud house, far away from the city. Elmer must hurry. If he doesn't get to the fields early, others may have already taken his place. His family depends on the small amount he brings home each day, less than $1.50. Elmer's mother, Maria Angela, also works in the fields during the rainy season. With what Maria and Elmer bring home working in the fields, they barely have enough to buy food for the day.
We can buy a small amount of food each day, maybe some grain for tortillas and some beans. This is what we have to eat.
Every day, Elmer's 5-year-old brother, Elan, must walk down the hillside near their house to gather water from the stream in plastic oil cans. It's not clean water. It's full of disease. Elan suffers from parasites because of the water, and he's malnourished because there just isn't enough food for the family. This is not an unusual story. Literally millions of families like Maria and her children are caught in the same cycle of poverty and hopelessness. But hope does not rest on survival. Hope springs from new opportunities and faith for a better future. Maria Angela's prayer for the future of her children:
I want all my children to go to school and to learn to read and write. I want them to study the Word of God.
When you decide to sponsor a child through World Vision, your gift of $22 a month will ensure that your child receives a quality education, nutritional meals, and improved health care. But what makes World Vision unique is that your involvement in a child's life means that you are involved in the family and the entire community. Since I have sponsored Elan, the family now has a new home like this one. Elan's mother, Maria Angela, has received vocational training and all of the children are in school. Enclosed with this video is an insert that will tell you more about World Vision Child Sponsorship. Fill it out and send it to World Vision along with your first gift of $22. You'll receive as our special thank you an audio cassette of hymns and voices. Make a difference in the life of a child. Sponsor a child today.
Thank you. Thank you. We are thrilled to be here with you, and this is an evening about worship. We are here to worship our God.
Shine.
My grandfather Paris was a minister. He was a gentle, unassuming man with a servant's heart and a tender love for God that never wavered. Grandma was the fiery, passionate one, but he was the rock at the center of our family. He also had a lovely tenor voice and was often asked to sing. Everyone's favorite was an old song about heaven called Sitting in White, which depicts the eternal scene of worship at the throne of God. He usually finished the song with a catch in his voice and eyes bright with tears. The last time I heard him sing, it was just a year before he died. At the end of the song, he said, "Won't it be wonderful when we know we finally made it?" At the age of 73, my grandpa suffered a massive heart attack and 3 days later went home to be with the Lord. I have two vivid memories of his funeral. One is a picture of my grandmother in a white linen dress. All her life, she'd worn white to funerals in honor of the resurrection. And today would be no different. She had told me that after living with someone for 49 years, you don't know how to live without them. And yet there she was, quietly declaring that her faith and hope were still in God. When Grandpa had sung Sitting in White for the final time a year earlier, someone had had the wisdom to make a recording. At his funeral, the tape was played, and as the song finished, we all heard him say, "Won't it be wonderful when we know we finally made it?" My grandmother lived for 14 more years. Though she never stopped missing her husband, she continued to be productive, joyful, and full of faith. And right up until her death at the age of 92, she still had that same fire. At her funeral, her 5 granddaughters were seated close together, all wearing white. Grandpa sang again, and once more we heard him say, "Won't it be wonderful when we know we finally made it?" Father, we recognize that all good gifts come from you, that you are holy and you are generous and kind. And we thank you for your love. We thank you for your mercy and for your faithfulness, that we can say we trust you, Lord, and we can be in a very secure position. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your presence here tonight. The joy that God places in our hearts is so much deeper and greater than any of the stuff that's going on around us in our life. This is your moment to celebrate the joy of the Lord.
The joy of the Lord is my strength.
with his light in her eyes. And how beautiful when humble hearts give the fruit of pure lives so that others may live. How beautiful, how beautiful, how beautiful is the body of Christ.
Enjoy the complete Twyla Paris Perennial Collection, featuring Perennial, cassette, CD, devotional book, and home video. For more information, call 1-800-991-7747. That's 1-800-991-7747.